Lorsque nous parlons de métabolisme
When we
territorial, nous
talk
voulons
about
mettre l'accent
territorial
sur la dimension
metabolism,
matérielle du
we
fonctionnement
want
des
to
sociétés
focus on the material aspects of how human societies live, because human
mais
societies
ça accompagne
need
aussi de
to
rejets importants de matière
take
dans la
and
biosphère. Le
also
reject
material. So
et de
metabolism is a way to group all these flows of energies and materials which are related to the operation of societies. The word metabolism is borrowed from biology, but it doesn't mean that we consider that societies are living organisms. We just take into account the fact that materials play a significant role in the way they operate. We use the word territorial because we consider that we need and locate societies in a given environment. Material flows bear a certain number of major challenges, and most environmental challenges we're faced with today, whether we take them in their social or environmental consequences, are related to material flows that we are going to focus on now. We can talk about climate change, which is related to greenhouse gas emissions, the eutrophication of river streams, which is linked to the presence of phosphate in waters. These nitrates and phosphates are also materials which usually come from the operation of human societies. We can talk about water pollution, soil pollution, exhaustion of resources. So, the current metabolism of society is currently linear. So, our societies are based on the continuous taking of materials from and sending of material to the environment. It's contrary to ecosystems that would take small quantities of resources in the biosphere and reject small quantities and operate thanks to renewable resources. Obviously, we are not saying that we should not use any materials. We need materials just to feed ourselves. The food chain is essential for us, like it is for all human living beings. But there is a challenge in better understanding this territorial mechanism and make it more operational so that human societies are more compatible with the biosphere. In terms of action, the challenges are called disconnecting or dematerialization. Disconnecting means consuming less material in order to produce one unit of wealth. Dematerialization goes one step further and shows that we need and consume less material, and we need to use renewable energies if, as I said before, we want to make our societies compatible with the operation of the biosphere.